Business salutations, YouTubes. I'm back, and today I'm talking about the world's most hyped game of 2014, Watch Dogs. Don't know why I was so fucking hyped. Goddamn storyline was fucking boring. I give a storyline about probably like a solid five. Not even a solid five, I just give it a five. Fucking 15.2% of the goddamn game is the actual storyline, the actual campaign. Everything else is just fucking mission based. And to be honest, throughout the entire game, I felt as though it was more of an obsession to find the person who killed his niece than anything else. Like, it wasn't more about, oh, you know, I want to get revenge for the person who killed the most important person in my life. No, bullshit. It was an obsession. Because he could have just found out who killed her, killed the boy, and then kept on going about his life. No, he did a bunch of other dumb shit that had nothing to do with it at all whatsoever. So, fuck it. And, like, alright. The person who ordered the mission is Lucky Quinn. The person who hired the person to kill you is Iraq. And then the person who pulls the trigger is named Maurice or some shit like that. I don't know. Fucking dumb. Then fucking, like, and then the ending to this game. You find out Damien is the person like, who you killed at the end of the game. It's not even Lucky Quinn. Lucky Quinn's like at the end of Act 4, I believe. You kill him, you got a whole nother act left. Which is fucking stupid. But yeah, Damien's the guy you killed at the end. He wants revenge on you for basically ditching him in the beginning of the game because of some shit that happened. Alright, the beginning, you start off the game, you're in a baseball stadium, and you're trying to hack the fucking CTOS, or I forgot, because I can't really give a fuck, I don't pay attention to it. So, and then, boy Damien finds another hacker, who finds out who happens to be Quinn, who happens to be Iraq. Iraq's there trying to get blackmail on everybody, and he obtains it. But Damien wants to find out who this other hacker is, and fucking Ada's like, no, don't do that. Fucking, you gonna fuck up what we're here to do. So, Damien didn't listen to Aiden, so that fucked up everything. Apparently, it fucked up their friendship. And basically, Damien wanted revenge for that. So that's why he's there. That's why he's fucking with Damien and shit. And that's why he's fucking with Aiden Pierce and shit. So, yeah, at the end of the game, you kill fucking Damien and shit like that. They converse. Wasn't the conversation that important. It's just basically saying you betrayed me, blah blah blah. And then the guy Jordy, who's been on your side throughout the entire game, comes the fuck up out of nowhere with a gun and say, "Oh, this is nothing but business." Like, noob, you've been with me this entire game. You knew you were gonna kill me at the end. Well, try to attempt to kill me at the end, and then tell me it's just business. And then after I kill fucking Damien, you gonna call me and say, "Oh, my bad, it was just business. It's a contract. Business first, pleasure later." I understand that, but goddamn, do you have to be fake the entire game? Why be fake? Why take on my friendship? I don't know. This fucking game pisses me off. It went everywhere and then nowhere. And then the fucking, every fast car that you need in this game, like you literally need every fast car that they had. None of them have handles. A lot of people might say, "Oh, you don't know how to drive, blah, blah, blah." No, none of them fucking have handles. Not a single fucking one. It pisses me the hell off. I played Need for Speed and more fucking cars fucking had handles better than shit. Fake ass Lamborghini they got in this dumb ass game anyways. Oh, man, get me some. Fucking just straight bullshit. The game was really, really hyped. It didn't need to be this hyped, to be honest. I don't know if they didn't show it in this E3. I'm pretty sure they didn't, but in 2013's E3, they showed it. It looked 1,000 times better there. That's what made me want to buy it and shit. But and then the online play, that shit's dicky. Because it's not like a different thing. No, that shit interacts with your storyline. And if you're getting hacked, your campaign mission will stop, and you gotta go kill this motherfucker. That shit pissed me off, because I got hacked like 3 times while I was doing a fucking mission. Why would you do that? They need to fix that. That's what they need to fix. Fucking What else is there to say about this fucking game? It's not horrible. It's just not good. Like, I know this review might sound like I'm saying it's fucking horrible. No, it's just not a good game. It's not horrible, but it could have been way, way better. To be honest, I think the storyline should have been a little longer. Because the longest act you have is Act 2. That's 15 missions. Act 2 is 15 missions long. The overall game, like the entire game itself, I'd probably give that a 7. But campaign wise, that gets a 5. And keep in mind, I'm not saying solid, so. I hope my next games aren't like this. Well, I just got PlayStation Plus, so time for some Battlefield. So that's going to be my next game review. Look forward to that, guys. Just like, share, subscribe. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. Give us a thumbs up. Share. Write in the comments. Tell me what you think. You think that Watch Dogs good? You think it's bad? Tell me what you like, what you didn't like. And yeah, man. Just have a good evening.